Mihály Csíkszentmihályi, the well-known father of positive psychology, was born in Fiume in 1934, the son of the Hungarian consul. The family left Hungary in 1944 and moved to Rome, where they operated a small restaurant. The young Csíkszentmihályi did not like Italy and emigrated to the United States. He was interested in painting, and he worked and attended university lectures at the University of Chicago. Later, he became head of the psychology department there. Mihály Csíkszentmihályi wrote his doctoral dissertation in the field of creativity. This led him to the understanding of the phenomenon of happiness, which he describes as flow experience, in one of his articles written in 1972. The theory became widespread only after 1988. Several of Csíkszentmihályi's books have been published in Hungarian: The Flow, The Psychology of Optimal Experience, and The Evolving Self. His books have been translated into more than 30 languages. Mihály Csíkszentmihályi is a member of both the American Academy of Sciences and the Hungarian Academy of Sciences.
Flow is a state of mind or an experience, a state of experience that we feel when we are totally involved in what we are doing. I began to notice how important this feeling is in the arts, for instance, for painters or musicians who, when a painter begins to fill a white canvas, a canvas with nothing on it, and he or she begins to put colors on this canvas and begins to develop a shape, develop a painting that will be important to them and to the public, the artist completely loses track of the time. They don't notice they're hungry, they're tired. They are just sometimes working for days without stopping. And that feeling that then they try to explain it to someone who wasn't involved in the painting, and they explain it as being completely carried away, almost like being in a river and the flow of the water takes them on. The state of mind has the same characteristics. Everybody describes it as being very focused, very clear goals, immediate feedback to the action, and a balance of challenges and skills. So this is the experience of flow as they describe it in art, in sports, in music, and every time a person is really involved in what they're doing. For instance, one of the most successful examples is a Swedish company called Green Cargo, which has been losing money for 125 years, and every year losing money. Partly, the only way they could afford that was that they were a government company of transportation, which were state-owned. And then a person who learned about flow became the human resource manager for Green Cargo, and he started applying flow principles in that company. And it turned out that after 2 years, for the first time in 125 years, Green Cargo made a profit, and since then apparently it's making still profit. But that's not the only company. There are many. Microsoft is using it. There is a company here close to Los Angeles, Patagonia, which makes clothes for outdoors for sports people. And that's a very good example of a company that is able to introduce flow in the work.